The United States re-emerged as a space power with human spaceflight capabilities in 2020, the thanks to SpaceX, when it launched the first crewed rocket launch from American soil, after nearly a decade of NASA depending on Russia to launch crew to the International Space Station. Since the government agency no longer developed its own spacecraft, it turned to private companies for a ride to the International Space Station, by creating the Commercial Crew Program. Think of NASA as a customer looking for an Uber ride, and its Ubers of choice were Boeing and SpaceX. They've been developing and perfecting their infrastructure for a decade before this moment. No one thought SpaceX would be first to send NASA astronauts into orbit. This is the story of why Elon Musk's company won the race against Boeing. Boeing was the giant of the aerospace industry, with a legacy stretching back more than 100 years. It seems NASA was banking on Boeing, when deciding the amount to give the companies to develop spacecraft that would fly astronauts to the ISS. NASA handed Boeing a $4.2 billion contract compared to $2.6 billion for SpaceX. Its Office of Inspector General, the oversight division for the agency, put it this way. NASA was willing to pay $90 million a seat to ride with Boeing, but only $55 million for a seat with SpaceX, assuming 4 astronauts for 6 missions. Musk pointed out it's not fair that Boeing gets so much more for the same thing, while Boeing disagreed with the OIG's report, explaining it will fly the equivalent of a 5th passenger in cargo, so the per-seat calculation would be less. With the funding, Boeing manufactured the Starliner. The Starliner had a test flight without crew to see if it was ready to fly astronauts. It was supposed to go to the International Space Station, deliver cargo, and return. Instead, there was a software problem, and that caused the engines to fire at the wrong time, and that put Starliner in the wrong orbit, so it never made it to the ISS, but it did make it home. NASA realized it had put too much trust in Boeing, which had a long history of supporting the space agency's missions. The head of NASA's Commercial Crew Program admitted, "We were, I would say, a little more used to the Boeing process." Musk once put it in a harsher way, telling the Washington Post Boeing was arrogant and complacent, and doesn't get out of bed for less than $1 billion. Boeing shot back by saying it helped NASA build the ISS before SpaceX was even born and will deliver on our commitment to America's journey to Mars. SpaceX is currently the only U.S. company capable of launching astronauts safely to and from the ISS. SpaceX and competitor Boeing are part of NASA's Commercial Crew Program that aims to conduct frequent, rotational spaceflights to the orbiting outpost from American soil. NASA purchased 6 crewed flights from Boeing and 6 from SpaceX, with duration of each mission being around 6 months. Initially, the agency intended for both companies to conduct alternate crewed missions to ISS, however, Boeing's Starliner development is falling behind. It has not completed the necessary testing to certify its spacecraft is safe to carry humans. SpaceX has already completed 3 operational crewed flights, Crew 1, Crew 2, Crew 3, and will also launch Crew 4 next year. On December 3, the agency announced it will modify SpaceX's commercial crew transportation capabilities, contract to purchase additional crewed flights, aboard SpaceX's Crew Dragon, due to Boeing Starliner development delays. The agency plans to acquire up to 3 additional crew flights to maintain an uninterrupted U.S. capability for human access to the space station. The announcement comes after NASA publicly requested the U.S. aerospace industry to submit information if they wanted to launch astronauts to ISS. Ultimately, the agency determined that currently SpaceX is the only company capable of safely transporting astronauts to and from the orbiting laboratory. After a thorough review of the near-term certified capabilities and responses from American industry, NASA's assessment is that the SpaceX crew transportation system is the only one certified to meet NASA's safety requirements to transport crew to the space station and to maintain the agency's obligation to its international partners in the needed timeframe, agency representative stated. NASA plans to secure the spaceflights with SpaceX to maintain planned crewed flights to ISS, going smoothly while Boeing continues to develop Starliner. "It's critical we begin to secure additional flights to the space station, now, so we are ready as these missions are needed to maintain a U.S. presence on station," said NASA's Associate Administrator and Space Operations Mission Director at Kathy Lutters. "Our U.S. human launch capability is essential to our continued safe operations in orbit, and to building our low Earth orbit economy, she said. NASA assured it still plans to alternate missions between SpaceX and Boeing. NASA and Boeing engineers are working side by side on the development of CST-100 Starliner spacecraft. Boeing has faced multiple issues that started in December 2019, when Starliner's computer timer malfunctioned during its first demonstration mission for NASA, causing it to fire its engines incorrectly, and it failed to reach the proper orbit to dock to the space station. Boeing stated the craft did reach a stable orbit, but it did not accomplish the correct altitude to be able to dock with the orbiting station. Then the company delayed their second demonstration mission, Orbital Flight Test 2, that was scheduled for December 2020. This year, Boeing had everything ready to conduct the Orbital Flight Test 2 flight in August, but the company's Starliner faced another delay due to issues with the vehicle's propulsion valves. NASA commends Boeing for its ongoing investigation of the oxidizer isolation valve issue that was discovered ahead of the planned uncrewed Orbital Flight Test 2 mission to the International Space Station in August. Prioritizing safety over schedule while working to solve this challenge, said Phil McAllister, director, commercial spaceflight at NASA. NASA and Boeing will provide additional updates on the status of Starliner's next mission as we work through the investigation and verification efforts to determine root cause and effective vehicle remediation, they stated in a press release this week. Another attempt to conduct the Orbital Flight Test 2 mission is planned for next year. SpaceX has landed the Falcon 9 booster many times in one piece, paving the way for the ultimate goal of developing a fully reusable rocket and spacecraft called Starship. This is, I think, the most inspiring thing that I've ever seen. The plan is to use Starship to send people to the moon, build a city on Mars, and for travel from one point to another on Earth. Reusability is crucial for keeping costs low in order to make space travel possible for everyone. This is the biggest difference between SpaceX and Boeing. The rocket that launched Boeing's Starliner into orbit cannot be reused. The Atlas V was developed by United Launch Alliance, or ULA, which is a joint venture between Boeing and Lockheed Martin. ULA has mentioned possibly reusing the booster engines of another rocket, the Vulcan Centaur, by catching them in the air with parachutes and a helicopter, although the company hasn't mentioned when testing will begin. Musk recently called ULA a complete waste of taxpayer money, because their rockets are not reusable. It's clear that SpaceX has a big lead over Boeing to the surprise of many industry veterans. But examined another way, it's not a surprise at all. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.